Upon launching the program, you'll see the project gallery, where you can choose a recent project, create a new blank project, or pick one from a number of pre-designed interiors and houses. We'll start by taking a look at the main window. It contains the inspector panel to the right and the library panel to the left, which can be activated by tapping the corresponding buttons. Now let's take a closer look at the library panel. There are three tabs here: Object Library, which includes the building elements and furniture, the Material Library, with all the supplied materials, and the Project Tree. The Project Tree is a breakdown of all of the objects included in the given project. Here you can control an object's visibility as well as lock and unlock it. Now let's take a look at the Program Toolbar. In the upper left corner, we have a hamburger button. It opens up the menu, which gives access to the projects and templates, import, export, and sharing options. The application settings and in-app store are also available here. Then we have undo and delete buttons. The delete button appears once any object or building element is selected either in 2D or 3D view. Next, we have a set of tools. In the popover are available straight and arc wall tools for drawing walls, the room tool for creating complete rooms, the floor, the ceiling, and the opening tools for creating custom floors, ceilings, and openings. The auxiliaries contain dimension and annotation tools, as well as camera and movie tools for adding user cameras and creating videos. Auto dimensions and guides are also controlled through this menu. To the right, we have a program inspector, but we'll get to that in a second. The next two buttons change the mode you work in. There is the 2D view for creating floor plans, and the 3D view for viewing and refining the interior. Note that if you use the application on a phone, or you're working with two apps in the split view, there could only be one button there for switching between the modes. The movement in the 3D is controlled with the gestures and a special movement wheel which can be found in the lower left corner of the screen. Live Home 3D offers two rendering modes for the sake of convenience and flexibility: shadows and lights on, and shadows and lights off, which is the faster of the two options. Now let's get back to the inspector. The first tab contains object properties where you can control the parameters of walls, furniture, columns, and other objects. Next, we have the Materials tab, which controls what materials are applied to objects. In the 2D Properties tab, you can alter the appearance of the objects on the floor plan. The Cameras tab contains all of the cameras in a current project. Here you can add, delete, and switch between user cameras and movie tracks. The Light Properties tab contains the controls to adjust the light sources, including the sun and moon. You can also change the geolocation and set date and time to get the correct sun or moon lighting. Next tab is Building Properties. This is where the new stories and auto roofs can be added and deleted. You may set the height of each story and adjust other parameters. Switching between the stories in 2D is also made via this tab. And that about wraps it up for the interface. Note that the Program Help offers a more detailed look at the program's interface.